What's up, guys? My name is Mark Steiner, and today we're going to be talking about the Sony 35mm f1.8. Let's get right into it. Let's talk about the physical traits of this lens. This lens is so small and so light, I was mind blown the first time I held it in my hands. This is very similar to the Sony 28mm f2 and the Sony 55mm f1.8. It's right in that size range, and it's mind blowing that they were able to do this so small and so light. It's incredible. This lens weighs a mere 280 grams and pairs perfectly with the Sony mirrorless system because it is so light and it feels like a feather on the end of your camera. It also has the other features we've come to expect from a Sony lens of this caliber. It has the AF-MF switch on the side, as well as a custom button on the side, and a nice little metal focus ring. Build quality is great on this lens, and Sony claims that there are 6 points of weather sealing on this lens. However, there is no rubber gasket on the back. Because of its small size, this lens has a 55mm filter thread, which is uncommon, which means you're probably going to need some step-up rings or to buy a new filter for this lens. Onto the IAF test. This lens is snappy. It's going to find the eye, stick to the eye like glue, and you know you're going to get your shots in focus, and at the end of the day, that's what matters. This lens also features a minimum focusing distance of 22 centimeters, which is pretty good given this wide-angle range, which means you can get pretty close to your subject and still get them in focus. This lens also features the brand new linear focus motor found on both the 24 and 400mm G Master lenses from Sony, so you know that the autofocus is going to be great on this. Not only does it mean that you're going to get beautiful fast AF, but it also means you're going to get very smooth transitions, and it's going to be much nicer to manual focus and pull focus manually. On to the video AF test. This is where I think this lens truly shines. Because of that new linear focus motor, it's going to give you that smooth transition and track your subject beyond compare, and this for me is a huge deal because I can rely fully on this lens. I also really love this lens as a gimbal lens. Because of its small size and weight, it can be balanced easier and be taken by smaller gimbals like the Ronin SC. And to me, that's a big deal because a small and light lens on a gimbal like that means I can keep my setup super light and I can just point my camera in the direction I want to focus and fully rely on the lens to do its job. On to some photo tests. I have a couple images here that I want to go through and explain what I love about the image and what's a little bit of a downside. As always, I will be leaving a link to some raw files for you to download and pixel peep and edit to your heart's content. Let's do this. So with this first image, what I can see here is that the background is blurred pretty nicely. This was a lower light situation, and it looks pretty clean to my eye. The thing that stands out a little bit to me is the colors look really nice, but that was edited with my editing and presets, so feel free to check that out. But here on the watch, you can see a little bit of purple fringing here and a little bit of green fringing here, which is a little bit unfortunate. And up on the glasses, you can see a little bit more purple fringing here and purple and green fringing right there, which is a little bit unfortunate, but overall this image is pretty sharp. It was shot at 1/50th, so that's why it's a little bit out of focus, just because sometimes it be like that. The background blur is pretty nice to me. It's not as circular or as creamy as I would like it to be, but also this is a 1.8 lens and it's pretty nice. So on to the next image. Here I took a close-up image of my drink, and as you can see here, there's a little bit of green fringing around the letters, which is a little bit unfortunate, but when you zoom out, no one's really going to be able to tell. It's definitely here on the sides and around these letters, but if we look at the straw, there's a little bit of fringing here too. Nothing too bad though. Overall though, I'd say that the background blur is very pretty on this photo, and I really like it. And the bokeh is pretty standard with this kind of Sony lens, a little bit cat-eyed, not perfectly circular, but it's very pleasing to the eye. Speaking of bokeh, here at Blue Hour, you can see that the bokeh is pretty pleasing, and overall, I have no complaints with this. I do wish it was a little bit creamier, but again, it's a 1.8 lens, and I have no problem with that. If we zoom in on the chain, you can see a little bit of green fringing here and a little bit of purple fringing here. Nothing that some lens corrections can't take care of, but it's a little bit unfortunate. On to the next set of images. It's pretty sharp here, and you can see that the eye is clearly in focus, but what I'm worried about with this photo down here is that when we zoom out and then zoom in on his shirt, it's very blurred and green, and I don't understand what's going on there. It kind of just like has a lot of fringing throughout the shirt, and I don't know if it's the shirt's color that's tripping up this lens, but there is a significant amount of fringing throughout the shirt. If we do undo the edit that I've done, there is significant fringing throughout the shirt, especially on the buttons, and I don't understand why there's so much fringing and mush going on in this shirt, which is a little bit unfortunate because clearly we're in focus and we're pretty sharp. So overall, this lens is fairly sharp, but it's not the sharpest. Bokeh again is pretty cat-eyed on this lens, so it's not the cleanest and not the most circular, but it gets the job done. So what are my final thoughts on this lens? It's small, light, and very reliable, and I really like that in this lens. It's a very versatile focal length, and this lens can be used for both photo and video, which is something I always appreciate from Sony native lenses. My biggest complaint with this lens is its chromatic aberration. I was kind of let down by how bad the chromatic aberration on this lens is, and I think that's the only anything that holds this lens back. In photo mode, I'm not too mad about it because I can fix it in post, but in video mode, it's much harder to take care of that. So that's kind of a bummer for me, but if you're only using it for photo, I wouldn't be too worried about this because you can just fix this with the lens corrections. The shining star of this lens for me is the video autofocus. It's so good that even if you own another 35mm that isn't this one, you might consider getting it just for that feature. This lens is priced at $750, and to me that's a bit of a letdown because this is in the same league as the Sony 85 1.8 and that is priced at $600, so I was hoping that this lens would also be priced around that. But the fact that it's $150 more expensive is a bit of a letdown. Because of that price hike, it's now being compared to the Sigma 1.4, which comes in at $700, and I've seen go as low as $650 on sale. So if this lens is in that same league as a 1.4, I feel like it needs to be just a little bit cheaper because of that 1.8 versus 1.4 argument. I did a whole video on this if you're interested in that, so be sure to check it out here. I'll probably link it in the description down below as well. But because of that price, people are going to be comparing it to the Sigma 1.4, and I think that's where we have a slight issue, that you're comparing a 1.8 and a 1.4, and I feel like the 1.8 should just be a little bit cheaper to be more competitive. Although those two lenses are very similar in price, I think the people buying those two lenses are actually very different. The Sigma is large and cumbersome, whereas the Sony is light as a feather, and I feel like people who are traveling or doing street photography and want an incognito lens, that's really gonna play into whether or not they buy the 35 1.8. So I wanna know what you guys think. Do you think this is a great lens? Do you already own it? Do you want it? Do you have another 35 and regret buying that and want this one instead? My name has been Mark Steiner, and I will see you next time.